Swimmers at Shelley Beach had a heart-stopping close encounter this morning, a bull shark darting between them. The alarm was raised and everyone managed to make it to safety unharmed, but the shark's real target, a dolphin, wasn't so lucky.
Hundreds of swimmers sent to shore after a shark sighting. A bull shark attacking a dolphin off Shelley Beach just after 7 o'clock this morning.
I just stood up and told everybody to get out of the water because there's a bull shark.
The dolphin, badly wounded, flailing in the shallows before it washed ashore and was pronounced dead.
Once I saw the flesh wounds, I realised it's quite sick.
Swimmers were in the water when the attack happened. The shark swimming right past them, focused on the dolphin.
I saw the dolphin come on my left side, saw a shade on my right side and just looked over and there was a bull shark, about 3 metre bull shark.
Then a search for the predator. Two bull sharks seen inside the aquatic reserve, emergency crews determining their location from the air and below.
Hopefully, a lot of them have moved on and these ones are just the ones that come in, feed during the day and then leave.
The closure's widespread.
There is to be no swimming along Manly today.
A national surf carnival cancelled, 1,000 athletes kept on the sand.
Highly dangerous situation. We do not recommend putting athletes in the water. We're not going to go against, marine biologists.
The dolphin will now be taken by Northern Beaches Council to Taronga Park Zoo. There, it will undergo further examination by specialists to determine the extent of the injuries and just how this morning unfolded.
It's just scary because you've combined flipper with jaws. The worst combination you can get.
Liam Tapper, 7 News.
Once I'd heard the shark alarm activated, I've come round and I was talking to some people and they said they saw two dorsal fins in the centre of the bay here. And it's not unusual to see dolphins because the dolphins will come in here to give birth sometimes. They swim around, but it was interesting that there was two dorsal fins, which made me think there might have been two dolphins. But then they said there was splashing and the dolphin had been hit by a shark, which is not unusual because sharks eat dolphins. But the size of that dolphin, not being that close to it, but looking at it, it's an adult dolphin. It may have been an older, sick dolphin that's come in to basically die. It wasn't with a larger pod. And you see large pods of dolphins off the coast here. But it was a sitting target, so it would have been hit from below. They're saying it may have been a bull shark, possible. Again, until you actually see the bite marks on there, you won't know. So obviously they've taken measurements. They'll take it away for further analysis to sort of give further insight. But I'm pushing that it's a sicker, older dolphin that was at its time to die. So
How rare is something like this to happen here at Shelley Beach?
So close to people with a major surf carnival happening, not that common. We get lots of sharks in here. There was a 2 metre hammerhead shark a few days ago. You get sharks coming in and out of here. We've got a resident colony of grey nurse shark, literally 300 metres around the corner, which will swim in here chasing bait fish. We've got wobbegong sharks, we've got blind sharks, we've got all sorts of angel sharks here. So it's a very popular dive spot for divers and snorkelers and swimmers. But to actually see nature happen right here, it's very confronting for a lot of people.
There's quite a large crowd here at the time.
Huge crowd, and more so when the alarm goes off, everybody pulls their cameras out to see if the shark's there. Helicopters, rescue boats, police, everyone's here, including me. But I'm more focused on finding out exactly what caused that dolphin to be attacked. Obviously, it was alive when I got here, and I'm keeping it wet, but it's bled out. There were no vets here. They're doing what they can to sort of help it, but we don't have anywhere to take it either. So if we did rescue it, where are you going to take it to? Probably Taronga Zoo. We don't have facilities anymore. And I think based on its injuries, they would have had to have euthanized it anyway to stop it suffering.